am I getting excited about a hug about this? There's only 6 minutes left, Chuck.
That's... Time is running low.
Can't they pull a goalie? The other goalie get nine people in there or something? However many they have.
Whatever they do.
They have 11.
11. Thank you, Lou. Loop them downtown. Whatever. It's 11 minutes after the hour here in the I'm in the morning program. Well, you just call Short Pants. Well, Short Pants has already been playing the Flatlanders. Short Pants was early on the Flatlanders, by the way. When the record was first released, he probably, except for people in Texas and Austin, Lubbock, Fort Worth, those areas, probably the first person outside of Texas to play them. My man Luther Short Pants was, so. And, of course, we're on Eyewitness News Talk 1310 in Albuquerque, which is, by the way, they don't play music, but it's a terrific radio station. And they've got great people. And a guy follows me there. The guy who used to be, hey, Randall, what's that guy's name? They're on 1310 who follows me. Bob Short. The guy's pretty good, Charles.
All right.
Used to be the DA.
Yeah.
And then he was indicted and he was in prison, right? And then when he got out, took a radio course in prison. Yeah. And now he's on the radio, so.
See, it works
out. Wasn't indicted. Oh, no. Apparently, it was not indicted. Let me retract that before Bob gets all bent out of shape. I got to call me in.
Yep.
So,
When's Sid going to Mohegan Sun?
Today. Why?
This just in, as they say. Former President Clinton will be in Uncasville, Connecticut today to be honored by the Mohegan tribe. The tribe is honoring Mr. Clinton for signing legislation in March of 94 that gave the Mohegans federal recognition. The ceremony is this evening at the Mohegan Sun Casino. And maybe that's something that Sid can check out.
Well, that's Mitchell Edis and even the members of the tribe, who I also have met, but I know Mitchell very well.
Yeah.
It's a great company. I'm not just saying that because they're a sponsor, because I would delight in hammering them if I could. But it's a terrific organization. They've done a fabulous job. You know, I'm not a big supporter of gambling and all that sort of thing. However, they provided thousands of jobs throughout that whole area in Connecticut.
Oh, yeah, this huge expansion they've done.
It's a 125-acre complex, and they run it as well as you can run anything. So it's coming up on 14 after the hour. Well, I went to Walmart yesterday.
God. How'd that work out?
Well, you know, I'm not a big supporter of Walmart because I think they ruined the guts of communities in this country. But, you know, I went to a local cowboy store in Las Vegas, New Mexico, to buy Wyatt Imus some Wrangler jeans, the stonewashed ones that are six regulars what he now wears. And there was no one in the store. And the guy there was pleasant enough, but didn't seem all that concerned about whether I was going to get any or not. Hmm. But did suggest I go to Walmart. I said, well, now, you know, the place sells Carhartt stuff. If you don't sell Wrangler jeans, I mean, you might as well close up now.
Sure. Quickly there, come on.
So I went to Walmart, and I mean, it's the last thing I wanted to do. I'd been up since 3 o'clock in the morning at 4 o'clock in the afternoon to drive 85 miles an hour before the stores closed to get to Las Vegas to get Wyatt some Wranglers.
Yeah.
The people, they couldn't be nicer. I mean, it's unbelievable.
Well, it's how they built their business on that kind of thing,
I mean. I mean, I walked up, I asked a lady, I said, well, where are the Wrangler jeans for kids? She said, well, I'll get them for you. Place is jammed with people.
Yeah.
Well, she goes and gets them for me. She said, if you need any underwear, I said, yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah.
Shopping for your grandson? how nice.
I do get that occasionally, you know.
Sure.
Well, now, not often, because he calls me daddy all the time, but so. Anyway, so, got that. And he's not taking a dump in his pants anymore, you know, he's potty trained.
That's good.
Oh, man, this is great news. This is one of my favorite people I've known for 25 years when he was, well, he was doing, boy, he started with David Brinkley. He was an assistant to David Brinkley, and then he was in news.
Yep.
Has a wonderful news background, which is he's a wonderful writer. He then was fabulous with CBS Sports, and he's the guy, by the way, who popularized a phrase, yada yada rolls on, which they all use now.
Yeah.
And then he said, well, I'm leaving CBS Sports and going to host Access Hollywood. And we thought that was a horrible mistake. Well, it turned out to be probably one of the best decisions of his life because it's an enormously successful program. Please welcome to the program. What happened?
They almost scored. It was
hit the side of the net.
Oh, God.
Sorry to interrupt this on-air BJ.
Well, I love Pat O'Brien. Good morning, Mr. O'Brien.
I thought they were all cheering because I was coming on. And here they're watching the frickin' soccer match.
Well, we apologize.
I'm sitting here thinking to myself, you know, I'm all jacked up on coffee because it's 6:15. I ran 4 miles.
Yeah.
I'm thinking to myself, it's obviously great to talk to one of my best friends, but they go, man, listen to the love from the guys in the back. And then they're talking about some bonus fake, almost couldn't do it goal.
Well,
what kind of love is that?
Well, I know, Pat. Well, I apologize for them.
That's conditional love, Pat.
Well, yes. Of course, it is late in this match. And you ever watch soccer? Good morning, Don. How are you?
I'm fine, baby. How are you?
I'm great. You ever watch soccer with somebody who actually knows something about soccer?
No, I have not.
Or listen to this crowd, because the ball will come midfield, and then something will happen where the knowledgeable person about soccer will go, oh, my God, you know, and you see nothing.
Why are they still playing?
All you see is a guy in shorts, you know, running down the field. So,
hey, Lou, 90 minutes is...
Well, that's not the official time. The refs have the official time on the field.
Oh, they do?
Yeah, because there's injuries, and they stop it themselves on the field.
Oh, okay. We should be up, like, 3-1 in this match.
It's probably close, though.
Hey, Lou, do you cut grass, too? Holy smokes, how do you know so much?
Anyway, how have you been, Pat?
Oh, I've got no life.
I've been great, you know, very, very busy.
Yeah.
And I called. I wanted to wish you a great summer.
Thank
By
you.
By the way, you know that Jack Buck situation down there? They put the casket at home plate?
Yeah. No, I didn't know that.
Did you know that?
No.
They put his casket, the great Jack Buck, by the way, at home plate last night.
Yep. Was he in
allowed
it?
Everybody, he was in it. Allowed everybody to, we don't know if he was in it, do we?
No, we don't.
So that could
was
be.
He, Charles?
If it was closed, I don't know. But it wasn't an open casket deal, was it?
That could be 1 hour of Jerry Nachman's show, finding out. Who I love, by the way. But anyway, I'd like, you know, if you ever go, maybe I could put yours over on my acre on the ranch.
Well, yes, you could. I was riding on your acre, as I told you last night, I was riding on your acre yesterday, but the day before yesterday, and I was riding Poker Sneak.
Yeah.
And,
I think you'll have an opening tomorrow for out there, so if you want.
And the horse, the horse had eaten a lot of hay, and, a horse took a dump on your acre, Pat.
Well, all that can mean is that my acre is much more fertile than, say, Lupica's or Andrea Mitchell's. And maybe if you get...
That's a good way to look at it.
Yeah, go out there and spread that around down there and plant some.
Sure.
Good Lord, that means life, Don. Good morning, Charles.
Yeah, okay. Your acre used to have a water view until, maybe it rained last night, so maybe it's not so water view this morning.
What happened to my water view?
Well, we haven't had any rain out here in 5 years. So, 19 after the hour time with Pat O'Brien from Access Hollywood. So, are you surprised to see Tom Cruise on a cover of Time magazine?
No, I mean, Tom Cruise is arguably, you know, one of, if not the biggest male star in the world. I mean, this guy attracts, whether or not his movies go or not, every time a movie comes out with Tom in it, it's the biggest thing happening. Currently, Minority Report, which I've seen. It's a beautifully done movie.
Is he sneaking in the back door of the teepee?
No, he's not.
Well, there's no back door in the teepee.
I'll guarantee you he's not.
Okay.
What would be wrong if he was?
And what's wrong with that anyway?
Well, no, nothing. I just
it's
wondered.
A big tent out there, but Tom Cruise is not gay.
He goes in the front.
You know, all those rumors that you always hear or see on the Internet. First of all, if you read the Internet, everybody's gay, which is also fine.
You know, the reason I'm laughing, here's why I'm laughing. Because Bernard, whenever I'm having a conversation with somebody, he types horrible things on my screen here.
Right.
And
wait a second. I type a lot of stuff on the screen.
What's your screen number or name?
No, on my monitor here in the studio.
Oh, okay.
You still sleeping with Puff Daddy. I mean, that's not good. Hey, what are you, on a serious note?
You know, that the hip-hop world goes right through me.
I did know that, yes.
Nice, a friend of mine. Puffy's a good friend.
That was in Puff's video.
Sugar's a very good friend of mine, as you know.
I know that. Well, I got Puffy, you got Sugar. There's an old East-West thing going there.
But Sugar hasn't got it done because Sugar was supposed to kill Puff Daddy when he got out of prison.
Or somebody.
I sat in Sug Knight's office.
Yeah.
And said, was that the window you held Vanilla Ice out of upside down? the day after he got out of jail, I asked him that question.
Did you think
he
it was amazing?
He had in his office he put fish in an aquarium.
Yeah.
What's so funny about that?
You had a problem with the
gravel, the thing.
Did you work for David Brinkley or Brokaw?
Oh, that's nice. Is this the Phil Donahue show? That's what I was calling in on.
Hi, everybody.
That'll be fine.
Where the hell was I? Oh, he's got this aquarium that has piranha in it.
Yeah.
And once every now and then, he throws a rat in there, and they watch the rat get eaten up by the piranha.
Right.
So if we could dump Lou in some kind of a tank right
no,
now.
No, not Lou. We love Lou.
I know we love Lou.
Nice.
Say,
show you his eel?
Sid Rosenberg had a good line on the soccer game, which we lost, by the way. It's over.
Done. 6 million goals?
Yeah. That's pretty good, huh?
Does Sid still think I'm a phony? Is that the...
No, he doesn't, do you, Sid?
Truth is, yes, I do.
Oh, you know. Sid, I ought to whip your ass. You can't talk to my friend Pat O'Brien, 25-year friend Pat O'Brien.
Hey, Sid, you're like Rudy Marsky, tried to get me out of sports for 20 years.
What happens, Sid, when you need O'Brien?
Well, then I'll call him and tell him how much I love him.
yeah, but O'Brien does like an elephant. He's not going to forget that.
Hey, Sid, did you realize...
He'll do an O'Brien on O'Brien.
Yeah, he'll buy it.
Hey, Sid, buddy.
Thanks.
Yeah.
Did you realize that if Castillo keeps this up, he ties or breaks DiMaggio's record on the same day DiMaggio did not make a hit? He ties it on DiMaggio's 56th day.
Whoa. Really? You should have never left sports, Pat.
No.
See?
That's amazing.
That is pretty amazing. Castillo had his 34-game hit streak last night with a base hit for the Marlins.
Who is this? Oh, okay.
He'll never get there because the spotlight gets so bright at that point that he'll never be able to handle it. But it'll be fun to watch him wilt under that light. DiMaggio had nobody watch him. People read about it the next day.
We're talking with Pat O'Brien from Access Hollywood. Do you ever hear from Giselle Fernandez?
No, actually, it's funny you should mention that.
What happened to her?
She works over Channel 5 here in Los Angeles.
KCLA, okay.
Morning News, which is a very popular morning news show.
Mm-hmm.
But I am anchoring the show with her next Friday as sort of a, I don't know what it is. Is it a gimmick? I'm a friend of that program.
Right.
FOP.
Sure.
And I'll be anchoring with Giselle Fernandez, so there could be some good... roll your TiVos.
Or it could be a retention convention, couldn't it?
It could be. You can get your TiVo if it works.
Yeah, it
roll
does.
Roll that TiVo up and you can play it back.
She's still asking about me, Pat?
Yes, she is.
24 after the hour. Here. Have we done any spots this hour, Lou?
It always begins with, who's that jerk?
Hey, Pat.
How's he get his hair back?
That was not necessary.
We haven't done any spots this hour. Now, you have the option of hanging on or...
What I got to do is I have to go do something at 28 after,
yeah,
as we say in the radio business.
25 years. See ya.
That must shut up, Sid, you jerk.
Waving my friend goodbye.
Let me tell you what happens. I hope they scalp you up there at Mohegan Sun this weekend.
Oh, too late.
I hope Cyndi Lauper comes on to you from the stage and wants to sleep with you.
Hope you go home to your hotel room and see your wife in bed with Cyndi Lauper.
Hey, Pat?
Sid probably lost so much money on a soccer game today, he has no home to go to.
Pat?
Yes, sir.
Thanks very much, baby.
I'm going to get your band on Access Hollywood, too.
Flatlanders. Let's get it on.
Flatlanders. Right. Love you, man.
Pat O'Brien here on the Amazon Mind. Bring on, you know, Pat, he is one of the best people. We make fun of him sometimes. He's a great guy. Isn't he, Charles?
He is he's generally one of the sweetest people you'll ever
run. Yeah, I mean, he's...
He's smooth with a V.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't get much better, Sid, than Pat O'Brien. There are a lot of phonies around, and I mean, he's in show business. What's he supposed to do?
Well, let me ask you this.
He's on Access Hollywood interviewing Puff Daddy and Pam Anderson.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? Do what we do.
It's 6:25 in the morning in California.
Yeah.
What could he possibly be doing in the next couple of minutes that he couldn't wait around 2 minutes for a commercial and come back with his friend from 25 years, the I-Man?
Because that's what you say. That's a graceful way to get off. That's all.
You'll learn.
You're sure. You a moron.
Rather than just saying this conversation's over.
Guess what's gonna take place at your sports report?
What's that?
Waving my penis goodbye.
It brings a tear into my eyes when I begin to
On Broadway, a celebration of intentionally forgotten, lost classics of American theater. Today, Rancho Grande, a little-known musical comedy which suffered from opening the same week as Rodgers and Hammerstein's brilliant Oklahoma. It's the story of a working cattle ranch built for children with cancer and its miserable, cantankerous owner. In this opening scene, a new group of kids is welcomed by the head wrangler with some cautionary advice as to how they should react to their virulent host.
Children, there are just a few things you need to know about Mr. Imus before you meet him. Perhaps it would help if you knew his likes and his dislikes. Luther, short pants and big long horns and ponies, huge cash advances and hammering phonies, flying off the handle and overreacting. These are a few of his favorite things. New York Times op-eds in the real Slim Shady, Greenfield and Russert, Bo Dowd and James Brady, Delbert and Kinky, the way they both sing. These are Mr. Imus's favorite things. Mets cowboy hats made of 30X beaver, torturing media underachievers, rubbing salt in your wounds until it really stings. These are the Imus's most favorite things. Don't speak to him, no eye contact, don't talk politics. He's tired and cranky and carries a gun, a certified war.
Soccer game in Germany, 1-0, or Dumps. Nitwit, nil, whatever. Right. 1-0, they lost it.
Yeah.
Got it done. Now, time now for Christy Musumeci with the...
Musumeci, what's up with that? E-man?
Well...
Iman?
Christy Musumeci. The Scum Report. Good morning, Christy.
Good morning, I-man. Big news coming out of London. The word is Billy Bob Thornton and Angelina Jolie might be breaking up.
What?
The Daily News reports she said to have moved out of their house because Billy Bob, now on his fifth wife, hello, was cheating on her while recording a CD in Memphis.
Wait a minute.
Ain't she got his name tattooed on her?
She sure does.
Come on. Sickening couple.
She carries his blood around her neck.
I know. Right. It's like,
yeah.
Well, I don't want your blood anymore, you cheating skunk.
Oh, God.
Take your blood and shove it.
Wasn't he slapping around the other one there before he hit it big?
Laura Dern.
Bizarro couple of the decade.
I think he's
somebody.
Too big between the legs for his own good.
That'll be fine. Can a man be a man?
He just spreading the wealth.
I don't have a problem so far here, but go ahead.
Spreading the love. Well, you know, if this whole thing is true, it's going to be a nasty split. They just adopted a kid from Cambodia, and as Chuck said, she's got old Billy Bob and a big heart tattooed on her arm. I never understood that. Why do you have to brand somebody's name on, like, you're a cow, for God's sake?
Well,
adopted a kid from Cambodia.
You answered your own question.
Isn't it enough to wear a ring? Hello? And Rush Limbaugh, who is 40 on the Forbes Most Powerful Celeb list, which I-Man was rudely left off of.
I'm not very powerful. What is the list? What's the criteria?
Powerful celebrities. So I guess, like, if your name's out there, you know, if you're making headlines, if you're seen on the internet.
Well, I guess I wouldn't qualify, so I can accept that. Just another, you know. Well, I'm a victim again, right, Charlie?
Clearly. Exactly. It happens every day.
Ashley Banfield on the list and not you?
Well, I'm quite certain that she is more powerful than I am.
Right.
Yes.
Well, anyway, back to Rush. Apparently, just back from vacation, didn't have the best of time. He got food poisoning on this trip, went to an undisclosed location. He was so sick, though, he had to miss the show for like a week, got dehydrated, and then it turned into the flu. So I guess he didn't hear when the waiter said, I wouldn't recommend the crab salad. It's rancid.
What?
Maybe the hearing there isn't working that well. Okay, I'll have the crab salad.
About him sitting on a bowl?
Either that or maybe his young wife is sick of him. She's trying to knock him off.
Who knows?
And Mariah Carey has not had a banner year in terms of business.
What?
Mariah Carey not had a banner year in terms of
business. That's right, before that, that's fine.
Compared to the previous young wife knocking him off.
Sorry, I didn't want to upset you there.
That's okay.
Mariah, also on this list, I'm in. She's number 7 on the Forbes list. So basically, what you need to do is make a horrendous piece of crap movie and a nervous breakdown in public, and you're on this list. Throw some plates in a hotel. But anyway, Mariah's bounced back, been out hitting the town here in Manhattan, pictured in the Daily News this morning, picking up a big, fine black man at a Manhattan restaurant. You see this picture in the Daily News? Wearing her tight little Levi's and getting the, she's 32, he's 23. They're
fine.
Got their little Palm Pilots out.
Well.
Writing in each other's numbers.
Well, pretty good. All right.
I'm telling you.
Could be riding down the lyrics to this thing here. Oh, good God.
I'm waving my heart goodbye. I'm walking in the crowd and I'm talking out loud and I'm telling myself, don't cry. And Lord, I'd rather not forget what I forgot, but I guess I'm gonna have to try. Standing in the station, I got no reservation. I'm waving my heart goodbye.
About 20 times. Tell him you talked to... What's the matter, Sid?
No, I like that song. I hadn't heard that yet.
Sid's next. It's 15 till the hour.
A one, two, three, go! How the girls all get prettier in closing time. How they all begin to look like movie stars. Taking place. It puts the glow on every face of the fallen angels, of the back street.
Yay.
But ConnectiCare has a solution. iPlans, the new generation of affordable health plans, only from ConnectiCare. iPlans can save you as much as 30% compared to our traditional HMO plan. And you don't give up the things that make your employees happy. Like access to the entire ConnectiCare provider network, award-winning personal service, wellness and preventive care programs, high satisfaction.
Sing it with me!
ConnectiCare's iPlans make employers pretty happy, too. Yeah! Call your broker or ConnectiCare today. Learn more about iPlans and get an eye-opening quote.
I'm Robert Warnock.
And I'm Bethany Warnock.
And together, we own New Jersey's largest family dealership.
With thousands of new and pre-owned vehicles to choose from and over 100 service bays, come and see what a difference we make.
At Warnock, we'll make it happen.
Whatever you're looking for in a car, truck, minivan, or SUV, Warnock's got it. Drive on over to our 6 locations and choose from the newest Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, Chevrolet, Ford, Nissan, and Lexus models, all with incredible buy or lease options. Looking for a pre-owned vehicle you can trust? We've got acres and acres of them, all priced to drive on home. Warnock, 6 locations in East Hanover, Morristown, and Livingston. For details, call 1-800-WARNOCK. That's 1-800-WARNOCK. Or visit us at warnockauto.com.
Warnock, we'll make it happen.
You've secured your network and your systems, but what about your internet-enabled applications? Is your email system infested with viruses? Is your customer information protected? Melillo Consulting can help.
Hi, I'm Mark Melillo, president and founder of Melillo Consulting. For 15 years, we've been helping our customers deal with the critical issues of the day and plan for the future. We provide complete solutions in enterprise management, e-business, storage area networking, and mission-critical infrastructure.
Join Hewlett-Packard, Tumbleweed Communications, and Melillo Consulting for a free seminar on protecting your business-critical communications. You'll hear from experts, including the New York office of the FBI, discuss the threats your company faces today and how to manage them for tomorrow. Join us at Madison Square Garden on Tuesday, June 25th for this important seminar, followed by a behind-the-scenes tour of the garden. Register today by calling 1-800-TEAM-MJM or visit mjm.com/security. That's 1-800-TEAM-MJM or mjm.com/security.
Ladies, this is the time of year we all dread, swimsuit season. The thought of squeezing into a swimsuit might be making your stomach turn, but JCPenney can help. They have suits with figure-enhancing underwires and control linings in the pattern of the season, tropical print. Or get a custom fit with a two-piece mix-and-match swimsuit in great tankini tops and flattering bottoms in a variety of styles and hot colors like sapphire, ruby red, and pink. Trying on swimsuits may not be the most enjoyable experience, but JCPenney will make sure you look good and feel great this season.
Don't worry, Dads. Mom will be home soon.
Who put Dad's cell phone in the dryer?
Where's your mother?
Mom's at the JCPenney Saturday one-day-only sale, June 22nd. There's 20 to 60% off store-wide, plus extra savings before noon starting at 8 a.m. It's all inside. Let the fun begin. Don't miss the JCPenney Saturday one-day-only sale. Percent off regular prices, extra savings on select merchandise. Some exclusions apply. See store for details. Good morning, I'm Lori McNichol for the Warnock Automotive Fan Highway Patrol. Here's what's going on the subways.
What's the matter, Lori?
Nothing. What's wrong, I?
No.
What?
I'm just complimenting Sid on how great he's been the past 3 weeks, and I also said your traffic reports have been stunning.
Thank you, I.
There's got to be something else out there for you to do, really, don't you think? I mean, some calling that's begging you to, you know.
Now, just because you're not interested in delays, other people are.
Well,
you know? I mean, a little limo lock for some other people.
Right. I'm well aware of delays when it comes to my penis, so.
What has that got to do? Where did that come from? Where did that come from?
Penis today, I
don't know.
A little too obsessed.
I don't know. I apologize for being...
waving my penis goodbye?
What you talking about?
Oh, my gosh.
Anyway.
Where's Wyatt?
Oh, Wyatt, what a nightmare. God almighty, I'm kidding. It's 9 minutes till the hour here in the Average Morning Program. We're having an intimate conversation with Lori McNichol, our traffic lady, and Sid Rosenberg, our traffic bimbo. I mean, our sports bimbo. And Chuck McCord. You know, Bernie Lou, of course. Bernard had his darling children in this morning, and I'm not patronizing him. They really are just lovely children. Brendan, who is 9, and Melanie is going to be 7 on July 1st. So, how did they stay awake the entire morning?
They did, yes.
Oh, they did. Well, pretty good, kids.
Digging the Flatlanders.
They didn't get in my safe back there. Is that how they're staying awake?
Some
anyway.
Benadryl pills.
Yeah. I figure I'll have that thing cracked before you get back in September, I mean.
So you backed up at 10 o'clock with, these phones on trying to find the numbers. I got 2 numbers already. Getting close. Floor plans all over the floor.
Like a Mission Impossible deal hanging upside down.
Gotta be 2 8 balls at least, Benito, you figure?
It's gonna be worth it, that's all I can say. An hour a day working on this thing.
So we lost a soccer game, huh? Match or whatever.
Ah, damn Germans, they did it again. Mm. 1-0.
One nil,
I should say. Yeah, we had a couple of opportunities. It was exciting. We thought we scored there late in the game. Pat O'Brien mistakenly thought we were applauding him. Nothing could be further from the truth.
Put your hands together for Pat O'Brien.
You really are wrong about Pat. I'm telling you that. You just don't know the guy, so.
He
hosts a Hollywood show. What's he supposed to do?
He hosts what?
He hosts Access Hollywood. What is he supposed to do?
Oh, right, the Nancy O'Dell show he's on.
It's not the Nancy nothing.
Oh, come on. She's the whole show. And I like Pat. Pat's actually a very nice guy and a very funny guy, and he does a great job on the show. But don't be confused. People watch that show just for her.
Oh, okay.
It's not to see Pat interview Sean Puff Daddy Combs.
She's just an interchangeable news bunny. When the interviews go down, he does the best job.
That is absolutely the case. The guy's a brilliant writer, by the way.
He is, he is. No, I like Pat. I really do.
He started out working for David Brinkley. I mean, he's not some chump who just, couldn't make it as an actor and decided to host one of the shows.
No.
I mean, the guy's a real deal.
Dopey bimbo.
No. He's actually brilliant, Pat O'Brien. Brilliant. He's really just a couple of months away from a Nobel Peace Prize.
Well, have fun this weekend at Mohegan Sun.
Well, thank you. I'm looking forward to it. And
of course, the former president, another scumball, Bill Clinton's going to be there tonight,
At Mohegan Sun?
Yep. Yeah. Right.
Come on.
Yeah.
No.
I did not know that.
So you were masturbating.
Maybe you could listen to the show, Sid, sometime.
Back at the safe.
Yeah, sit back trying to crack my safe.
Or at least turn that little speaker on back there as you're cracking.
Yeah, there's right over there by the jukebox, there's a little speaker. You listen to the show.
Make him think that you were paying attention.
Yeah.
Is he talking about me again?
Wow, that's great. I can get in here and I can do the show. He'll never know.
So Jody McDonald must be really happy you're getting all this attention, huh?
Well, yeah, it's good for the show. We're having a good time, Jody and I. Things are going well.
How's it good for Jody?
Whatever's good for Jody is good for me. Whatever's good for me is good for Jody. We're a team.
Jody is the Nancy O'Dell of your program. I mean, we could bring in Ian Eagle. We could bring in Eric Spitz, for God's sake.
No, that's actually when I go away on vacation next month. Ian Eagle's going to replace me. So, see, so it works both ways.
When are you going on vacation?
Oh, I'm going away next month, in a couple of weeks. I'm out of here for 10 days.
While we're on the air?
Yeah.
I don't think so, Sid.
Oh, really?
Why can't you coordinate your vacation with ours?
Well, because I didn't know I was supposed to do that. And Tuesday, I'll be married 10 years. This Tuesday, June 25th.
That's going to end this weekend.
So you can't come in from Coney Island?
When you and Al Shannon are making googly eyes at each other.
You, Al Shannon, and Clinton.
Come on. All there with your pants around your ankles.
Won't be a scandal that way.
Well, you with your pants around your ankles, anyway. No.
I did not have sex with that man, Sid Rosenberg.
Yeah, win big wampum, yeah. You...
Great, jeez.
Hey, look at this, Sid.
Oh, boy.
Have a great time, Sid.
Thank you, Iman.
I'll see y'all in a couple of weeks.
Price may vary with digital cable or satellite TV.
Copyright 2002, Infinity Broadcasting. All rights reserved. Imus in the Morning is a presentation of WFAN and Westwood One Entertainment.
The flagship station for New York sports is The Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York, an Infinity Broadcasting Station. WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good morning, it's 10 o'clock. I'm Joe Tolleson. The United States World Cup dream has ended with a 1-0 loss to Germany. And this report brought to you by Panasonic Ultra Compact Digital Cameras. So small you can take them just about anywhere, because sometimes the best moments in life happen when you least expect them. See them at the Wiz. And that's what's happening. I'm Joe Tolleson with 2020 Sports and WFAN, the flagship station for New York Mets baseball.
Six minutes after 10 on a Friday here in New York. Smack and sit on The Fan. I'm Jody McDonald along with my partner Sidney Rosenberg. Hello, Sidney.
Hey, Jody, how are you?
Okay, and yourself?
I figured you'd be all pumped up, all excited, feeling great.
Pretty much. You and I have discussed this before. Some people get excited about vacation before they go.
Right, that's me.
I get excited when I get there.
When you're there, huh?
Because it's either flying or driving or packing, or I got 176 things I got to do before we head down to the Jersey Shore. So when I get in the place that I'm going,
then you'll be
pumped. And I kick back and I have my first cold beverage of choice, that's when I get pumped up.
I was just saying to you, you know, it's a strange day for me, because it seems like whoever I work with today is not going to be here on Monday. The I-Man's gone now for 2 weeks. You're gone today for a week.
We're all getting out while the getting's good.
Yeah, exactly right.
Well, the getting wasn't good for the U.S. today. They didn't want it.
2 lanes of the southbound Cross Island and 1 lane of the westbound LIE from 12:01 a.m. to 8 o'clock p.m. Expect delays. With reports every 20 minutes, I'm Joe Tolleson, WFAN 2020 Sports.
The home of Imus in the morning and Mike and the Mad Dog in the afternoon is The Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
It's really sad how we ride around crowded airport parking lot.
Florida, we'll make it happen.
The sports leader, Sports Radio 66, The Fan, WFAN, New York.
For 41 years, Ken Ham.
Monday.
Planning on it. Thank you much. Have a good week. Keep an eye on Dovinetti. See if you can get Dov to drop a couple pounds. Eddie to add a couple. He's melting away before our very eyes. And Ian will be in with Sid next week, so keep it tuned here. Congrats to Patrick Paleo of Jamaica. He won the Blitz going to the Mets and the Yankees next weekend. Thanks to Eddie and Sweeney and Clint Mathis as our guests today. And Dovinetti for keeping us on the air. Dog going solo this afternoon. He's got 3 pair of Subway tickets to give away. Flash sponsored by your Tri-State Chrysler dealer, Chrysler. Drive equals love. Have a great week, everybody. Here's Tolly.
The flagship station for Imus in the morning and New York sports all day is The Fan. Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York, an Infinity Broadcasting Station. WFAN 2020 Sports.
Good afternoon. It's 101. I'm Joe Tolleson, the U.S. run of the...
Fan.
The Mike and the Mad Dog radio program today on a Friday, the 21st day of June, the year 2002. Nice to have you with us. Busy day today indeed, with Eddie Robinson is checking in today with Mark Malusis, filling in for the vacation, and Chris Collin, the Mike and the Mad Dog crew, to think it is 6:30. Nice to have you with us. Mike has a very bad throat today, so I'll take you home on this Friday as we get ready for summertime. And Mike can barely talk, so that's where we stand with that. Nice to have you with us.
Yeah.
Square Fun. All weekend long. This is WPLJ, New York.
All right, it is 11:53. If you got to be somewhere for lunch, hurry up. Time is flying. Let's get to Ron in Bergen County. Ron, you're on the air. Speak out.
Kill it. Toss it. Throw it out. Give me something. Give me something. That's a beat. The other one's done. 718-937-6666. It was a slow starter. I thought maybe it would get revved up. Yeah, they just tossed it. That's gone. See ya. Get Dove Kramer on the phone. We're on the fan. Mention the baseball talk. We can do that with interleague play. Are you still excited about interleague play? Or has it gotten to the point, if it's not Mets-Yankees, you just don't care? We'll get your thoughts coming up.
Want to talk New York sports? Call us at 718-937-6666 or go to Fan Instant Access on the web at .com and get us an instant message. It's powered by the Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
To be alone.
Reporters crowd around your house, going through your garbage like a pack of hounds, speculating what they might find out. You don't matter, you're all washed up.
Therefore, I shall resign the presidency effective at noon tomorrow.
Don't know where things went wrong. Might have been when you were young and strong. American Dream.
Neil Young and Richard Nixon.
American Dream.
And, enlightening conversation with the great Ben Bradley.
Fascinating.
And MSNBC, those dopes are going to cover the entire panoply of what happened in Watergate, and it'll serve as an education. It's a good idea. All day on MSNBC, they'll have interviews with the people who were involved in it, and they'll all this old footage they have. Probably Brokaw's interview, which was a terrific interview with Richard Nixon back in 1988, I believe it was. Some of the reporting that John Chancellor did. So that's all day on MSNBC. It is now 11 minutes till the hour here on the Iverson Wayne program. Sid was on a little earlier with the sports, and he would be precluded now from and prevented from ever mentioning the Mets again on this program until something's done to rectify what is a disgraceful situation, in my view, that they didn't put up 85 or 90 mile an hour fastball right between that fat moron's eyes instead of throwing behind him, right, Sid?
I don't disagree. I don't. I think that Met fans will come out today and say they got the vindication. Estes hit a home run. Piazza hit a home run. They crushed Clemens.
That's enough. No more Mets stuff.
No more.
Mets mention. Next time you mention the Mets, you even try to sneak one in like that cheap, sleazy Mo Vaughn mention. Appropriately named, by the way, Mo Vaughn. Then you'll be suspended. So you can report. You know what you can report?
What's that?
You can report golf. You can report tennis.
I'm tired of golf.
You can report World Cup soccer.
We won. We beat the Mexicans today, 2-0.
All right.
How about that?
Yeah.
And I got dirty late in the game. They picked up five cards, which are like penalties, and one guy almost got thrown out of the game. So they resorted to get dirty, the Mexicans, but we still beat them.
Mm-hmm.
And now we got the Germans coming up next.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you know how bad I want us to beat the Germans.
I would imagine about the same. That's about probably about the same way I feel about it.
No, not the same. No.
Very similar.
How's that?
Well, it just is. I'm a Jew by inspiration.
Oh, okay.
So, 10 minutes till the hour.
1, 2, oh, 1, 2, 3.
I'm a in the morning.
I don't think it's too much to ask. I wanted an SUV that doesn't look like a delivery truck.
Oh.
Like lies, and how do they know what's good?
know when they want to catch a really great show. They take the number 4 to see the Bombers.
Hey, guys, with the new premium Transit Check Metro card, the world's best fans can now get unlimited rides on New York City Transit subway and local buses. All day, all year long. From Battery Park to the ballpark.
He means the Flushing Meadows.
No, he means the Bronx.
It's your ticket for savings, too. This pre-tax benefit could save you up to $200 or more a year. And if you're a suburban commuter, the premium Transit Check program can save you up to $400 or more a year. Talk to your employer about premium Transit Check today.
It's the best way to bring all New Yorkers close together again.
Yeah, except for another all-New York World Series.
For details, call 1-800-331-CHEK or visit premiumtransitcheck.com.
Because we New Yorkers deserve the best.
How do you achieve success? With critical information from the McGraw-Hill Companies. Standard & Poor's, Business Week, and McGraw-Hill Education provide the information that can change your future. The McGraw-Hill Company.
Hi, honey.
Hi.
I've been driving around the neighborhood, and I'll be darned if I can remember what color our house is.
Blue.
Blue, that's right. I've been so busy lately, I feel like I've hardly been home.
You want me to stand in the driveway and wave so you don't miss it again?
Okay, now, are you a blonde or a brunette?
Redhead.
That's right, a tall,
short
blue-eyed, blonde-eyed. Redhead, right?
Right.
Right.
Here's a Boston Market combo that can't be beat. A quarter dark chicken with 2 regular sides, cornbread and regular drink for just $4.99 plus tax. That's right, just $4.99 plus tax. See store for details. And remember, Boston Market caters. Boston Market. Slow down.
Interleague play continues tomorrow night as the Mets host the Minnesota Twins at Shea Stadium. Game time is 7:10 with Mets Extra at 6:30. This is Gary Cohen. Ted Robinson joins me to bring you all the play-by-play right after Mike and the Mad Dog here on your flagship station for Mets baseball, The Fan, Sports Radio 66, WFAN, New York.
I'm Lori McNichol for the Toyota Fan Highway Patrol. Starting in Morris County, eastbound Route 80 bumper to bumper for 8 miles into exit 30 due to an earlier multi-car accident. All lanes have been reopened. Southbound New Jersey Turnpike's eastern spur is barely moving past 15W, where there's a multi-vehicle accident involving a tractor trailer, bus, garbage truck, and 3 cars. Only the right lane's open in both directions, and southbound traffic's backed up to 13A. Also, the northbound western spur is crawling from the mixing bowl through 15E, where a stall's blocking the left lane. On the southbound Palisades Parkway, the accident's been cleared at exit 13, but it's still slow through the area. This report's brought to you by St. Clair's Hospital of Northwest New Jersey. St. Clair's Hospital salutes its nurses. Their skill and compassion help to provide the best in community-based health care in Northwest New Jersey. To join their valued and respected nursing team, call 973-537-3900. I'm Laurie McNichol for the Toyota Fan Highway Patrol.
Coming up on the I'm a Someone program, I have some distressing news to report.
What's the matter?
Luther Short Pants Watts.
Yeah?
Who I like, by the way. Actually tried to call me.
Oh, my God.
No, he didn't. Who?
Man.
He had the nerve to pick up the phone and try to reach the I-Man?
How many times do I have to cue you, Lou?
I'm a sin in the morning.
They say a dollar isn't what it used to be. They may be right. Since 1995, the price of stamps is up 14%. The fast food burgers we all enjoy so much are up 26%. A gallon of milk is up 40%. 40%? That's a lot of percent. At the MTA, we're always looking for ways to give our customers more value for their dollar. Take MetroCard, for instance. Free transfers, free rides, and special discounts have made the average fare decrease over the last 5 years from $1.50 to about $1.06. That's about a 30% drop. 30%? That's a lot of drop. So, it is true. A dollar isn't what it used to be. In our case, it's worth more. MTA, New York City Transit, Long Island Railroad, Long Island Bus, and Metro North Railroad. One system that gets you where you want to go. And with MetroCard, faster, easier, and less expensive. MTA, going your way.
Just keep driving, relaxing in the sun, whatever. Your Tri-State Lincoln dealer brings you the following summer reading. Quote, the Lincoln LS is as refined as anything from Lexus or BMW, with gobs of power on demand and a ride that comfortably bridges the gap between Lincoln's smoothness and the solid Teutonic feel of a BMW or a small Mercedes. That's from PBS's Motor Week. Then there's this. The Lincoln LS is one of the 5 safest cars of all time, from Insure.com. And Motor Trend wrote, if you're considering a BMW, Mercedes, Audi, or Lexus, put the Lincoln
Michael,
LS.
Good morning, yourself.
Hey, you! You're moving the truck or what? I'm talking to you! Yes, me in this cab! Yes, me! I intercourse your mother! Mr. Amos!
Yeah.
You are great Satan! You must immediately stop disrespecting my princess! Lori is my woman, you're not to make the fun of her!
Right.
This controversy you attempt to incite, pitting news girl against traffic girl, it is drop daisy cutter on my personal life! Since wife. She's so upset. She's not performing her physical duties. I'm not receiving cardinal favors. I am paying fortune for this wedding. I must be given some kind of incentive to go through with union. It's on Tavern on the Green. What do you think, a physicist and a traffic reporter is why I'm driving a cab moonlighting? So if you must pit these two women against each other, at least do it in a pit. Mud wrestling. I must be compensated. So give to me the news woman. Christy make hot sake. We make news together. I have update for her, if you know what I'm saying. I make her go... Hey, tell Corky Lang to play a theme for Imaginary Western. Mountain rocks.
More than ever before during the Office Max 14th anniversary.
All right, if you keep this up.
No.
What is it you're doing tomorrow?
I have to work, Donnie. I'm sorry.
Work where?
Well, I have to go to New England. I got a game on Saturday instead of Sunday.
So you can't make a telephone call at 9:27 Eastern time tomorrow morning.
Well, do you want me to call you from the car and all that, and, you know, get disconnected and all that, and miss all this quality time together? Would you want me to do that?
Please welcome to the I'm a Morning program from CBS Sports, former Super Bowl winning quarterback for the New York Giants, Phil Sims.
Man, you know, I am so low maintenance, it's unbelievable.
Well.
It's unbelievable.
Anyway.
Who are you kidding? All the people from Fox and Dan, you, Cowtown, have to do everything there is in the world.
No, no. We don't do anything.
You ask me,
We do. We do. No, they ask us to be on, by the way. We're not going out of our way to book people from Fox to appear on this program.
Oh, that's, I like that.
Okay.
Okay.
So you're doing the Patriots and Raiders.
Yeah, I do. You know, I have a dilemma, though, in my personal life.
What?
I had some extra clothes brought in by the cleaners. I don't know what to do. Should I keep them or should I send them back? Or I was thinking about wearing them today. You know, I don't know.
Can you believe that?
I can't believe it.
I mean,
I'm driving my son to school.
Yeah.
And my son, you know, he's in a daze going, oh, my God, another day of school. He turns and looks at me and goes, is he telling the truth, Dad? Yes, son, I think he is.
Yeah, well, that's the absolute truth.
Oh, that's unbelievable. unbelievable.
And you know, I did think, and I didn't say anything, because, you know, you wouldn't think that. But I see him coming to work here the past 2 days, and he's got these shirts on, and they're laundered very well. And
yeah.
But they're clearly a little large on him. I thought, well, maybe he got them as gifts over the holidays.
Oh!
I didn't notice how many they were. I just noticed on a couple of occasions. Well, we're talking about Sid Rosenberg, who got a bunch of shirts from the cleaners.
Unbelievable!
That are not his, and he kept them and has been wearing them.
It must have been an upgrade. That's why he kept them, right?
Oh, they're clearly better looking shirts than what the other stuff that he wore. He has a shirt on today that's a cheesy shirt that looks like he got at Bancroft for about $4.99.
Well, I just wanted to clarify that it was true, so
yes,
I guess it is
true.
Now, listen, you got to take this MRI today, I hear, huh? Your shoulder? What's wrong with your shoulder?
Well, it's much better because I've been working out here for about 6 weeks, so they've made dramatic improvement.
Yeah.
And it almost doesn't hurt at all anymore. But Dr. Bronson suspects, or wants to at least find out, if there's anything torn in there, and if it needs to be operated on, or if there's some sort of exercise program I can continue, you know, whatever.
Yeah, have you done an MRI before?
Yes.
Yeah, for your shoulder? Because, you know, you got to go in head first when you do your shoulder.
Well, this is an open MRI.
Oh, that's no fun.
Well,
I was going to say, how are you going to go when they stick you in one of those little tight tubes and, you know...
You don't go.
Oh, my gosh.
No, sir, you don't do that. You just go in and open MRI.
Yeah, I won't do that. Close one.
I had to do one for my shoulder once, and they stuck me head first in there.
Oh,
and
my God.
Put your arm over your head. You're like, can this be any more uncomfortable? And about after 20 minutes, they go, how are you doing? And I said, I pushed a button. They said, you okay? I said, no. Take me out now.
Amen.
You know, I don't care. I'll take the surgery. And it's just, oh, my gosh, those things are, it's terrible. But whatever.
Well, I'm taking my iPod, and I will be listening to Willie Nelson and Delbert McClinton.
There you go. Not bad. That's the way to do it.
Little Stevie Nicks, Kid Rock, Paul Simon, Eagles.
Fine.
Dwight Yoakam.
Okay.
Good Lord. So, well, you can't pick the Patriots-Raiders game because you're doing it, so I will.
You pick it.
There's no way... No way that the Raiders go up there and beat them. None. Zero. That won't happen.
You know what? You're kind of right. Because it's going to be hard because the Patriots did have that week off. And I know the Raiders offense played really, really well last week against the Jets. But, you know, people keep losing sight of the fact that the Raiders defense didn't play very well either. You know, it really struggled stopping the Jets offense. And you know, Bill Belichick and all those guys up there have been scheming plays, getting ready for this Oakland Raider defense too. And that is a really good crowd up there. They make a lot of noise, and they make it difficult for opposing teams. So it's going to be really hard for the Raiders to go up there.
And this game, as Phil mentioned, is on Saturday. Also,
Saturday at 8.
Yeah, 8 in the evening.
8 in the evening, yes. It's going to be a little chilly up in Foxborough.
Now, earlier in the day, probably around 4:30, will be the Bears and the Eagles. And that game is in Chicago. And
and we know it's going to be horrendous. Hey, a good day down there will be. Chicago is...
I like the Eagles in this one.
You do?
Yes.
I like the Bears.
Well, no.
You know, it's not like neither one of them really like make me thrilled, but I like the Bears again for the same reasons. Home, week off. They like to try to run the ball, and I think their defense is, I think it's very sound, and I think they can stop Donovan McNabb down there. So it'll be close no matter what. The Bears can, if they completely dominate you, they'll still only win by 6 points. So, but I think the Bears will find a way to win a really close game.
By the way, I've been a Raiders fan all year.
Have you really? That was your team from the... I was going to ask you, who was your team from the start?
Raiders.
The Raiders. So now you're...
No.
Here we are, and you're going to jump right off.
No, I'm not.
It's a crucial time of the year.
No, I'm not. Even though I think the Patriots will win, I'm still picking the Raiders because they're my team. So I'm going to write down Don Raiders. That's the deal. Now, Sunday, what could be one of the great games ever, if they get that bus loaded up, Jerome Bettis... The Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Baltimore Ravens, and the game is in Pittsburgh.
Right, it is, yes.
Oh, man, I mean...
Yeah, a lot of people pretty excited about just wanting to see it. And I even heard Mike Francesa yesterday say he thinks whoever wins the game is going to go to the Super Bowl.
Right.
And, you know, that, of course, that could be true, but it will be exciting. And just,
what do you like in that one?
Oh... Because, you know, as you can tell from the previous weeks, I'm a horrendous picker.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, but that's beside the point. So are you. So's Fred. So's everybody. I like the Steelers in a really close game.
I'm a better football picker than you are.
Well, what the hell's that saying?
Well, nothing. But
that's not saying anything.
It's at least saying that.
That's just, you know.
So let's not be disparaging me because you don't know what the hell's going on. You can play okay, but.
I can talk about them and all that stuff, but to try to pick these things, my gosh, it's the hardest thing to do in pro sports or when you're wanting to be a bet man is bet professional football.
Now, I'm picking the Steelers, too.
You are.
But I would not be surprised if the Ravens won, even though the line is 5 points.
Is it? I'm surprised it's that big.
No.
I'm surprised.
It opened to 6.5.
Yeah, the Ravens, when we came on the air last week, we were getting ready to do the Miami Dolphin game in the Ravens. I came on, I said, look, I'm saying this as a compliment, but the Ravens, by far, are the most arrogant group of people I've ever been around. I mean, they just have. I've never been around them in the last couple of years when you talk to them where there's ever any doubt about the outcome, about their ability against the other team and this and that, and you just go, wow. And they're so strong in their beliefs, you walk away going, well, they convinced me.
Oh.
And, you know, that's just the way they are, and they play that way, too. You know, it starts from the coach, and it goes all the way through to all the players.
But I just,
But it's going to be fun to just to watch it
yeah.
and to see how it goes along. I know early in the game there will be a lot of pushing and shoving. You're going to, you know, you'll probably have a few personal fouls, that type of stuff, because in the same division, I think they both know, they both feel like if they win the game, they're going to go to the Super Bowl. So they're going to feel the pressure early. It's going to be a lot of fun to watch.
Talking with Phil Sims from CBS Sports, Phil and the Walter Hudson of sports will be doing the game.
Now, who's Walter Hudson?
He was that guy who, I think he's from Queens. He weighed 1,000 pounds. When they had to cut his house down to get him out of it.
Wow.
So
who are you referring to when you say that?
Greg Gumbel.
Oh, you kind of sound like Dennis Miller throwing that Walter Hudson thing in there, you know.
So the Rams and the Packers, that's the other game on Sunday. And the Rams are favored by 10 points.
Well, that's because everybody loves the St. Louis Rams. That's
yeah.
just what it is. And are they a 10? I don't know. I think that's about right, too, Don, because I think the Rams, they're so explosive. They're so much faster than the Green Bay Packers. And, you know, again, that's kind of like what I said about Chicago. They can dominate the game and only win by 6. And the St. Louis Rams, you can hang in there and be winning, and all of a sudden the final score comes up and you lose the game, and you can lose it by 14 or 17 points because they score that quick, that easily. And, you know, the difference with the Rams this year over last year is that they can score points and create a lot of turnovers with their defense.
I changed my mind.
You did what?
I'm picking the Ravens.
You're picking the Ravens?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm also picking the Packers to beat the Rams.
You are?
Yeah.
Now, that is not going to happen.
Well?
That is not going to happen.
That's stupid.
What?
You can't be doing that. That's stupid.
It's stupid?
Yeah, okay. Well, same. Okay.
You know, you two were fighting when I came on the air. I like that. You know, keep it up. I like hearing you two get in arguments.
No, the way
you leave and Charles just let the show fall apart, huh? Is that what happened?
No, we weren't fighting. It's just Charles writes these horrible things about people and then tries to lay it off on me. Well, I contributed to it, but I didn't write... I didn't write the...
You drew the parameters.
Charles is just following orders like the good, you know...
Right, like a it's good like, Nazi.
Right,
like
and you're Hitler.
And this is Nuremberg.
Comparing me to Hitler, I think, is a stretch.
No, I think it's accurate.
The point is that he's following orders.
I know that, but he goes too far.
From an evil man.
What?
From an evil man.
Exactly. Following orders of an evil man.
Wrinkle-up old jackal.
Wrinkle-up old jackal?
Right.
Do I have to take this?
Yeah,
yes, I do.
I guess so.
Man, you know what? You have lost control of the house.
No kidding.
Hey, you have lost control.
You know how he hurt his shoulder, by the way? Patting himself on the back for that Shug interview. Shug Knight interview he did last week, remember?
Hey, did you have to buy him some chapstick after that one? You
know, shut up.
My God.
All right. You're going to need an MRI on a good deal with you.
This is high maintenance Phil talking to Don.
We had him power wash his nose. It was so brown.
Bend it over, I tell you.
All right, we'll watch. Well, of course we're going to watch. It's the only thing on.
Hey, absolutely watch it. It's going to be good.
All right, Phil. We'd watch anyway.
See you next week.
Thanks, bro. Phil Sims here on the Iverson Morning Program, who has become a great guest,
yes,
hasn't he?
Yes, sir.
The best.
Yeah.
He's become a terrific guest.
Solid.
And remember when he first used to be on, he wasn't awful. He
was path. He was too much of a gentleman is what he was.
Right. Exactly.
No, he's great.
He's terrific.
Now he's bloodying noses like the best of them.
Yeah.
I get by with a little help from my friends. Oh, gonna try with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends. I get high with a little help from my friends.
Nikon introduces the coolest digital camera.
Oh, it's me again, Manuel Antonio Noriega. I know you've been hearing a lot from me lately, but to be honest, I got a lot of free time on my hands with not a hell of a lot to do except lift weights and try to avoid being made an involuntary participant in a pink pickle prostate probe. But I just couldn't let this presidential election controversy slip by without adding my perspective on the situation. Because with all the allegations of fraud and chicanery, protests and demonstrations, the riots in the streets, it really makes me homesick. In fact, if there were just a couple of chickens and a dead body somewhere in the mix, I would swear it was election day in Panama. Do you know, if W had only staged a bloodless coup in the first place, he wouldn't be in this mess. But if he was smart, which we all know is already a dead issue, once Gore's concession call came through, Georgie should have assembled what we call a transition team back home. A f***ing firing squad. Is there the appearance of impropriety? Well, I don't know. You have a guy up only a little over 300 votes out of 6 million, and he gets the edge in a state where his brother is the f***ing governor, not to mention the fact that his old man was the former head of the CIA? Nah, everything's on the up and up there. However, by the same token, it's pretty weak for that other Gumby-looking bastard to start crying do-over just because things didn't work out the way he thought. It's just that once again, it's a case of the lime green, polyester, sensible, pant-wearing old bastards f***ing it up for everybody else. The Democrats are whining that these old bastards didn't know that they were voting for Buchanan. Oh, yes, they did. They just thought it was James Buchanan, because that's the last time any of them possessed the mental acumen to vote. These colostomy bag-wearing, cream corn-eating curmudgeons have a hard time deciding whether to get the soup or the salad with their early bird specials. How are you going to trust them to elect a f***ing president? The way they're always on the highway in the left lane going 12 miles an hour with their flashers on, they shouldn't even be allowed to drive. Why the hell should they still be allowed to vote? The Eskimos have the right idea. Once the pubes turn gray, it's time to get up on the f***ing ice floe and go quietly out to the land of the eternal sunset. Then all of those funds for Social Security and Medicare could be taken out of that f***ing lockbox and put to some good use by those of us who still have a pulse to enjoy all the things that kind of money can buy. Abuelo, happy birthday. You're 75 today. Time for you to go live with your honorable ancestors. Just be a good boy and sign this check before you drink this Drano, okay? Tell Jesus I said hi. Cause in session there's some aggression. Dub, you can't take possession till there's a concession. Contest and reject, cause is an effect. Country's still short, but president-elect. Justice is miffed if you get my drift. Bush is on a mission to make the transition. Not sure if his effort's gonna come to fruition. He's just trying to uphold the family tradition. A patrician, politician, consumer's blind ambition. I'm sick of watching him bicker. Give me my channel clicker. Arguments about a shake. He has Dick Cheney's bum taken, made it through the campaign without succumbing to the strain. It wasn't very long till he's complaining about the chest pains. Look out, Dick, you don't want to get sick. Leave the heartache to James Baker. It'd be a deal breaker for a VP to need to wear himself a pacemaker. And it really would be a political heartbreaker if before the undercounts are under control, they gotta call out the undertaker. Obstacles to be surmounted, every vote must be counted. Seems the sore loser man's campaign's been remounted. Don't want to admit defeat. Voter tally's incomplete. Good thing Lieberman didn't give up that Senate seat. Look out, Joe, time for you to go. Though you say you'll never quit, don't let this thing go on indefinite. Stop complaining about the lack of that voter etiquette. And shut the hell up, go back home to Connecticut. Started a war. Thought that you were guaranteed, but Bush and Cheney disagreed, and virtually their victory officially has been decreed. If you weren't so conceited, refusing to concede, you could just kick back, smoke yourself some more of that wacky weed.
The ultimate getaway, one of the most spectacular casino destinations in the country. Room, that could have easily come to blows.
I think it could. I don't think that's an exaggeration at all.
Yeah. Good.
There's a difference between ridicule and hatred.
That was great.
Ridicule is great.
I mean, that was on display.
But hatred, you can't.
Yeah,
hatred.
there was genuine enmity that there.
Absolutely.
On Francesa's part.
Yes,
on Francesa's part.
Steak,
I think, is just kidding around.
Yeah, he goes just along with him.
Pushing it.
Yeah.
Steak is just trying to push Mike's buttons.
Exactly, and succeeding.
And succeeding.
And succeeding.
Yeah.
And he just jerks. He's playing Mike like a puppet.
Right, like a violin.
And Mike just reacts and...
Mm-hmm. He bites on it.
Yeah. He went for it hook, line, and sinker.
Yeah.
That wasn't necessary, Warner. He bites on it. You got a hammer, Mike, too?
No.
Is that a fat joke?
It's an expression. No.
I wouldn't make any reference regarding teeth, Warner, by the way.
No. See, that's ridicule. No. That's not hatred. No.
But
I
don't think it sounds good when Mike lets it get to him, do you?
Yeah, because it's... Oh, here we go. Right. Wait a minute. All right, now we do. Okay.
Doesn't sound good when you let...
Oh, let's not analyze this too much. I'm having fun. Jeez, come on, huh?
Yeah,
I hear
great.
The guy knocking me. You know, come on. Listen, anybody, he wants to make a big deal out of me. I try to pick one sleeper in the Final Four every year to have some fun with.
Well, he had a good point.
If the team leaves in the loses in the first round, who cares?
He had a good point. You should have known the score last night's game.
Why?
Because you're the guy. Good job. Because you're the man.
Now, listen. My job is at 1 o'clock today, and I'm the best prepared guy doing this anywhere, okay?
Well, hello. You're a guest on our program. Why do you think we book you all the time?
That game is inconsequential to the tournament. Totally. Now, listen, you guys can do this all day. I don't care.
Well, why do you think we book you? We book you because you know what's going on.
Shouldn't even be played, no less there be any consequence to that game last night. It meant nothing.
But it was.
Yeah.
It meant nothing.
You're the sports doctor, and you came up a pill short.
That team will be out of the tournament by halftime of its first game.
Did you hear what Charles said?
Nothing.
Did you hear what Charles said?
No, what did he say?
He said, you are the sports doctor.
Right.
And you came up a pill short.
No, my job was to pick the Final Four this morning, which I came in and did. And know that Jordan story. If I didn't know the Jordan story, I would be in trouble. That game, which should not be played, that I did not know the score of that game, I couldn't care less. I would have known it by 10 o'clock this morning when I sit down and do my work, which I didn't do yet this morning.
Well, you don't look at appearing on this program as
doing my sports work? No. No, I had to pick a Final Four by this morning,
We count on you.
Wait a second. If you tell me that you want me to give you the scores from last night, I would always give them to you, and I know everything about the games, but I obviously did not pay attention last night. I was out last night, and I didn't do it.
Where'd you go?
That's none of your business.
Were you with Parcells?
No, I was with my wife.
How's that working out?
My wife is working out great.
Okay.
Working out wonders. She's a wonderful woman.
Does she know the score?
Does she know the score? You wouldn't know the score, and you're sitting there.
Thanks, Mike. Hallelujah, you be my bodyguard. I can be your long lost pal.
Scene beat. I'm Larry Michael. Boxing After Dark returns to
Sports Radio 66, WFAN New York.
This is WFAN New York. And
potpourri here at 5 as we take it to 6:20, the Mike and the Mad Dog radio program here on Sports Radio 66. The big item of the... Well, listen, it's tennis. I understand that, so I don't want to make it out to be...
Just, Sid.
Yeah.
We were commenting about Sid Trash and Mike Breen and Mike and Chris's trivia deal.
Right.
And Carlin says to Sid, so do you think you're better than Mike Breen? And the appropriate response would be, no, I realize I'm not.
Certainly.
But Sid's response says, I think I'm different.
You know,
the implication being that...
Well, of course.
Yeah.
Certainly. I know what the implication is. Yes.
Hey, man, it's apples and oranges.
Oh, my God.
I'm not saying better. I'm saying different.
What do you do with a guy like that?
You suspend him.
Who's, you know, that troubled of an individual.
Suspend him and fine him a week's pay.
Guantanamo Bay.
Holy cow.
I mean, there's somebody who is so far removed from any...
Oh, man.
...sense of reality that is shocking.
But he, you know, he reveals that, not to that degree, I'll admit, but you see that at least subtly, and more so, all the time from him.
He needs help. I mean,
the whole shirt deal is...
And he's a Mike Tyson fan.
Oh. Right.
Thinks Tyson, he said Tyson is the greatest athlete alive today.
Convicted rapist.
Yeah.
And a dirty fighter.
A convicted rapist, a dirty fighter, and a scum.
A serial rapist, perhaps.
Yes.
Possibly. Not to mention serial adulterer.
Yeah. And then here's where he's... Do we have that cut where his comments yesterday?
Some reporter said something to him?
I'll look for it.
After that, that was after the craziness, this huge brawl at their introduction yesterday. Well, when they settled it down, and some reporter said, yeah, you ought to be in a straitjacket.
It is.
That set him off.
This is an interesting America Online instant message. Tell Sid to shut his mouth. He can only hope to be in the league of Mike Breen.
Oh, my God, yes.
Please off Sid. Take him out to a field and shoot him like a farm animal.
Well,
we don't...
No, I mean, I can understand the sentiment, but I certainly wouldn't want to see that done.
Imus, that parody sucks. For some real Taliban and other parodies, you should check out humafewbars.com, the ultimate parody site. Do we know about that?
No.
Maybe Rob should check that out.
Possibly.
He will now.
Who wrote this Dock of the Bay? Bob Grant? Is Bob Grant still on the radio, by the way?
Yes, he is.
Oh, he is?
Yeah.
How's he doing?
Get off my phone. He's still alive. He's breathing.
He says, get off my phone?
Oh, stuff like that. Oh.
I think he's calmed down.
So where are you from? What country are you from?
When are you going to see that Rob sucks? Now Rob's getting it.
Holy cow. Okay. Well... That's not good.
Hey, I-Man, has Rob actually ever heard a black man? Does he have any idea how stupid he sounds when he tries to imitate him? What a big, fat dope. Let Bernie do the black voices. At least he has a clue what they sound like.
Signed, Minister Farrakhan.
Tell Brokaw to take the marbles out of his mouth or swallow his Rice Krispies before he talks.
Well, this is all vicious.
He did get caught up on a smart aleck there.
A little.
Tom Brokaw made a crack about having to clean up Fred before bringing TV cameras onto the ranch. Maybe Tom would like to give Fred the name of his plastic surgeon who did such a good job on him this summer. 2 months off in the Western Mountains, and he returned without even a crease wrinkle.
Oh,
that's a little ugly, isn't it?
Hey, but yeah. I mean, please.
Climate. Senator McCain is a war hero, but he's no Republican. His stand on campaign finance reform, gun control, and other issues have made him the water boy for a host of liberal causes. And to think I sent him money and voted for him in a primary makes me shudder. Somebody from Boston.
God, is anybody happy about anything out there?
Well, no, but you know what's precipitated all of this ugliness is Sid.
Setting a tone.
Here's Mike Tyson, whom Sid thinks is the greatest athlete in the existence of athletes.
The cut?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can't touch me. You're not man enough. I'll eat your ass on a line. How anybody in here can't with this? Man, this is the ultimate, man. Fuck you, you hoe. Come and bang my face. Fuck your ass for that. Everybody. Come on, you scared coward. You're not man enough to fuck me. You can't last 2 minutes in my world, bitch. Look at you scared now, you hoe. Scared like a little white scared of the real man. I'll you till you love me.
Something like a
racist on top of everything else.
Who's gonna pay money to watch this guy?
And they had a ticket tape parade for this guy up in Harlem. He needs to be put to sleep.
Somebody's gonna pay
this
for
moron.
Pay-per-view?
That really is just disgraceful.
Holy cow.
Euthanize Tyson. There should be a movement.
Yeah, right, do you think that's amusing, Sid?
Well, I think that,
Here we
yes.
go.
I think it's a barbaric sport, and I think Mike Tyson is a barbarian. And I think at times he's entertaining, yes.
Well, you can fight and be a gentleman. I mean, Ezra Charles was, sure. Joe Louis was,
Floyd
Rocky
Patterson.
Marciano was.
Muhammad Ali? Oh, he wasn't.
Ali was no absolutely. Gentleman. Ali was a big
Ali
mouth.
Ali was a jackass.
I mean, all Tyson does differently is throw curse words in there. That's the only difference. I like Mike Tyson.
You are.
I feel bad for him, actually, sometimes, because he's obviously a little wacky.
You like the fact that he rapes women.
First of all, I don't like that, and there's no proof of that.
Wait a second, he's convicted.
He went to jail.
Well, let me just say this. That whole Desiree Washington thing, to this day, I'm not sure was not a God King
setup. He's convicted in Arizona right now.
Wait a second, he's not convicted.
Now he's about to go down again.
Well, if he goes down again, that's one thing, but I'm still not 100% sure that he wasn't set up by Don King and that whole Desiree
Washington. God almighty.
He went to jail and Don King stole all his money.
Oh, my Lord.
Lord.
I'm not saying the guy's a gentleman. I'm not saying that, but I'm just...
Blame the victim, Rush.
Here's what you want to do.
Right?
Holy... Just get out of the studio, or I shoot you.
Take your knuckles up off the floor and take yourself out.
Yes.
Holy Midday's on the fan.
Come on now. Here to try to defend himself.
The bitch set him up.
Oh, God.
For this,
She had it coming.
Hey, Rob.
Are you kidding me?
Rob, have you heard of this website, this song parody website?
No, I just clicked on it. It doesn't look like it's that great.
Well?
What is it?
I mean, they're doing parodies of Bad Company and Blue Oyster Cult.
Well?
And for everyone who sent those lovely thoughts on AOL, eat me.
Wait a second. I think I found Sid's Ike Turner cassette in here.
Ike Turner had a lot of good hits.
All right, here now, on the I Miss the Morning program, speaking of all that, is Mike Tyson.
Straight jacket, they want to put me in a straight jacket. They better have a big-ass butterfly net, too. Because they're going to put me in a nut house like one floor with a cuckoo puff. They're going to catch me first. I'm not afraid of you. I'm on a Zoloft. I don't care. I'm a seething pool of molten rage. I've been fighting for 20 years. I got about $12 a show for it. Don King flying around in the gold-plated G4. I'm taking a razor scooter to my day job at Mickey D's. I'm a fighter. That's what I do. No matter where it is, in the ring, in the bedroom, at a press conference, I fight. I don't care who it is. Bell rings, I start swinging. Lennox Lewis is a punk-ass bitch. Brother look like Moise and talk like Prince Charles. But once I'm done with him, he'll look like Princess Diana. I'm going to kick that bird Sugar's ass, too. I'll yank that Indiana Jones-looking hat off his head, roll up his stinky cigar in, and take his rectal thermometer with the whole mess. Stephen Hawking, I don't care who he is. He'll be part of the cosmos once I'm done with him. I'll put a handicapped spot in his behind pocket, a wheelchair his up in there. Doris Kearns Goodwin, I'll kick her ass. I don't care. She's so good at history, I'll make the bitch history. But now I'm a good feeling froggy, huh? Santa Eden, euthanasia. I don't care. Bring them little Chinese kids around. I'll kick their ass, too. One from column A, two from column B, fill them up like an origami fortune cookie. Come on, Bernard, you think you're so bad. You ain't nothing. You're so bald, you put on a turtleneck, you look like a busted condom. You're so bald when you shower, you get brainwashed. I'll draw a line down the middle of your head so it looks like an ass, and then I'll kick it. Or maybe not.
Mike Tyson here on there.
Wow.
I'm smart.
He's mad at me.
Sounds so he might be.
Yeah. We'll exercise.
Yo, mic check.
Woo.
Testing. 1, 2, 12.
What up? I'm Miss in the morning.
Visit your local Mazda dealer and test drive the...
In the morning. All right. Let's get right down to where the rubbers meet the road.
What?
125th Street, Harlem. New, headquarters, if you will, of Bill Clinton, the 42nd president of the United States. So the locals are all in a lather, right? Mm-hmm. Poor saps. Here comes their noble champion, their, you'll forgive me, white knight, ready to give something back, right? Excuse me, but last time he gave something back, if memory serves, it left a stain, didn't it? Great. Here's what I want to know, I do, as the great rehabilitation of Bubber begins. Who the heck is this buffoon's press agent? Lizzie Grubman, or worse? You would have thought, wouldn't you, that whoever booked this big new office opening would have, like, checked the date, maybe? Because, as God is my witness, Bill Clinton, intern predator, opened his new office with the big street party and everything on July 30th, which just happens to be the anniversary of the cops breaking the case that led to Megan's Law. You can't make this stuff up. And here's the sad part. I don't care what the bastard's done. He is never going away. He's got more gigs than Dennis Miller. He gets between 100 and a quarter and 250 large a pop. His friggin' checking account's got $1 million in it. Chicks are still throwing their panties at him, and he's BS'd these gullible saps in Harlem into thinking he's on their side. Jesus, why couldn't this guy have been me, dammit? Oh, well, let's move on to the next Megan's Law candidate. Gary Timey Kangaroo Down Condit, the modest lad from Modesto, California. Looking at his dance card, J.D., I gotta wonder whether he didn't have some sort of arrangement with Bubber, because between the two of them, is there a female in Washington, D.C., or wherever, who didn't get nailed? Frightening implications, Dono. Bubber was commander-in-chief. Condit's on the House Intelligence Committee. Do you suppose somebody could explain to these morons that, like, the Gaza Strip isn't a titty bar? Jesus! What else? Oh, yes, I agree with you that it doesn't reflect well on the program, J.D., to have Warner Wolf, an icon in his own right, for goodness sake, doing walk-on, no-line bit parts in these B-movies that are all going to go direct to video. Awful image. And I don't care how many he does, he's never going to get a principal actor's part because, well, they've already done the Toulouse-Lautrec story. Cheap shot. Speaking of people who appear in your very fine show, I do. Am I hearing right that some of them aren't that hot about appearing on your very fine show? What's up with that? The head lice who run MSNBC order their minions to call up, like David Gregory at the White House and Andrea Mitchell on the Chandra beat? I heard Miss Mitchell the other morning saying she'd really rather be at the gym at that hour. Well, of course, she's married to a human wrinkle, the chairman of the Federal Reserve. She's over there at the gym checking out all the six-packs on the pec deck machines, thinking about the ABX's Gary Condit Memorial tie sale and somebody getting funky with her monkey, if you know what I'm saying. Well, attention, MSNBC repertorial staff. Don't do us any favors. You don't call us, we won't call you. There, I feel better. Time for my exit anyway, Dono. I leave you today with those time-honored words that define the Bill Clinton presidency, said to the intern as she was leaving. Don't hit your head on the desk. Ouch! Bit of a muddled clutter in the old Dixcope today, inspired by the programming menu of MSNBC. You give us 24 hours, we'll give you a migraine. As will Dick Nixon, for that matter, a former president of the United States.
Not many Puerto Ricans where I live now. I live in Los Angeles. There's about 200,000 Puerto Ricans. In one room. But it's better than the neighborhood I grew up in. I grew up in New York City in an area called Washington Heights, which was like a ghetto suburb. Slums with trees. Even the birds were junkies. And dope addict sparrows who didn't know how to fly. Just fall out of trees and bother people, right? Tweet, tweet, sucker, give me a quarter.
I'm a sin in the morning.
Calling you any pain.
The hell happens in your feeble mind to cause these utter cataclysms of rage? Happen over nothing, over absolutely nothing.
Well, I've gotten better, though, don't you think?
No,
not at all.
I haven't gotten any better over the years.
No, you haven't.
You've got just better for a little while.
You did,
and now you've reverted back to the old.
You're right back.
The honeymoon. Literally and figuratively are over.
If your radio sounds funny in the morning, you're listening to Imus in the Morning.
I admit that I have sometimes lose my temper. What can we move on with this? I admit that. Well, what's wrong?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Well, I've admitted it.
Fine.
I'm going to try to work on it. What more do you want, Bernard?
There's nothing more you can do.
Answer me, you bald-headed geek.
I want you to pass away.
No, you don't want me to.
That sums it up. Anything short of that, it's not satisfactory.
I don't see how that solves anything. You people wishing me dead. How does that solve anything?
I don't know that it does.
It probably doesn't.
In the morning.
This is WFAN New York, an Infinity Broadcasting Station. I'm Robin Walensky. I'm in the morning news time, 8 a.m. It is 71 degrees. This news report is a service of Soap Talk on SoapNet. Soap Talk, the new daily talk show with Lisa Rinna and Ty Treadway, available only on Soap.
Secure, vicious individual.
Paranoid.
And paranoid beyond anybody's ability to describe it, and not that bright. And so... Dennis Miller, who is a pretty wrapped up in himself and a wise ass, but is brilliant. And we look past the point. We look past the part of Dennis being pretty enamored of himself. So that's fine. Maybe he should be. And we like him. I do. So, and Dan Fouts, I think, is terrific. But it is not only do they look as though they could be related, Dan Fouts and Dennis Miller, they look easily like they could come from the same family. In listening to their voices on television, you can't tell the difference. So if they're both talking about football, you don't know who's talking. The problem with Dennis Miller, now Dennis, something spelled with Dennis Miller, is Dennis Miller will say something amusing and clever. Al Michaels will never cue out of that as a punchline. He will never leave that alone. In other words, Dennis Miller will say something, and Al Michaels will always have to try to top him or add a remark.
Right. I'll offer something.
It would be like every time Lou or Bernie or you or somebody said something, if I then felt that I had to add something to that,
mm-hmm.
rather than just Q and Lou. But he does not, he's too insecure to do that. So, for example, I'll tell you who else is like that, and it doesn't make him a bad person in this case, is Rob.
Oh, my God.
If you have, what's the matter?
Talking about Monday Night Football.
No. I'm illustrating a point.
Not doing anything wrong.
If Bernie says something funny, or if I say something funny, or if you do, and Rob's in the studio, he cannot not say something. He is incapable of doing it.
Go, baby.
He can't do it. He cannot do it. But in Rob's case, Rob is not a vicious, mean, though he is slightly paranoid and enormously, astonishingly insecure, which many of these artists are, for whatever reason.
Yeah.
But in the case of Al Michaels, it's psychotic. And so Dennis Miller will never have the, I mean, he made a remark about the Pope. Al Michaels had to add something to that. Dennis Miller had a line about the Pope, some Pope going over the line or something.
Yeah.
And Al had to add a puff of white smoke line. I mean, it's just so absolutely unfunny and unnecessary that it was bone-crunchingly annoying. But in the case of Rob...
Yeah, what about it?
Well, I don't know. Why do you do it, Rob?
Do you think I'm paranoid? What do you think I'm paranoid? Are people talking about me saying I'm paranoid?
Now, how predictable was this?
Oh, man, you are vicious.
How
good
predictable
Lord.
Was this?
By the way, how come you don't want us to promote your play anymore?
It's not that I didn't want you to. I think you've done more than your share. You've done more than enough. We've been extended a week.
Yeah.
We're selling out. Mm-hmm. Kicking butt and... I mean, do you really think I'm insecure?
No, but you can't allow... Yeah, well, I've worked with you for 12 years. I know how you are. It's not bad. I mean, it's just...